For six generations, my family has lived here, in this far corner of West Virginia, along the Maryland border. Their stories run through my veins. When people ask me where I'm from, my answer never changes. This is home. I've come to the Gates family farm to meet my cousin, Dolores Ann.
I'm so glad to see you.
You look great.
I feel such a deep connection to this place. You see, my great-grandparents bought it in 1906, and my daddy was born here in 1913.
So our property went from here, along this fence, all the way over to Patterson's Creek, and also on this side, beyond the farmhouse and where the silo is, all the way up to Plum Run.
But the family was isolated, cut off from other black people, and from an education for the Gates children. So in 1928, they sold the farm, and along with it, a sentimental piece of our family
history. This is where my great-grandmother Maud resided, Cumberland, Maryland.
My cousin Johnny still lives here. We had heard that during the 1890s, when our people's hopes were at their lowest, Maud helped found an all-black Episcopal church, St. Philip's Chapel. We've come to talk to Father Chapman at the Emmanuel Episcopal Church to hear what he knows.
So this is the original list of St. Philip's congregation.
So Mrs. Edward Gates.
Yeah.
That's Maud.
Yeah.
Pansy, their daughter, my great aunt Pansy. Boy, I wish Daddy could see this.
Skip and I have talked over the years and always thought that Edward, Skip's grandfather, my great grandfather, was the one who was driving the family to the church here. But it appears through records that Maud was the first. So that's pretty amazing in itself. That she,
so Maud dragged them all. So we have no idea why these people broke off.
I just think it was some combination of the spirit of the times and also an effort at some kind of self-actualization. This was an opportunity to have something that was theirs. And nobody could push them around.
Hmm. Hello, come on around.
Hey,
how you doing, buddy?
Good, buddy.
How you doing, beautiful?
I'm fine.
Come around here.
Our mother and father.
So that's my grandparents.
Yes. Mm-hmm. In their marriage, my brother was arrested for trying to rob a drugstore.
And what street do you think the drugstore was on?
Green Street. And the Gates lived on Green Street. So Fred didn't think anybody would recognize him.
He got from here about down to that building.
We have an interesting family.